Buddy. So, some of you have heard this before. If you have, I'll just get you to be, restrain yourself for a moment for the rest of you. It just so happens that in the Catholic Church, we have a ritual that celebrates sex. Oh yeah, we got a ritual that celebrates sex. Woo! Yeah, and the opening hymn goes like, wow, 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 wow. Absolutely. We have a ritual that celebrates sex. Can you guess what it is? It's a wedding. That's right. A wedding is a celebration of sex. But I never say that during my weddings because grandma in the second pew will have a heart attack. Bang. Today we gather because John and Mary are going to have sex in about 6.5 hours. Never say that, but you know what? Everybody knows it, right? In fact, they are not validly married until they have sex, until they have consummated their marriage, right? Absolutely. So, what am I talking about? Premarital sex. Let's start with that one. How many people think it's okay? How many people think it's really good? How many people think it's a sin? How many people don't know? All right. How many people don't want to know? Would rather live in ignorant bliss on that one. Okay, well, before we get to the question of whether sex is a sin, what makes a sin a sin? One at a time. Yep.
You have to know it's wrong.
Yes, you have to know that it's a sin. Okay, what else? Yep.
You intend to commit the sin.
You have to intentionally commit the sin, yes. Uh-huh. Say again? Okay, good. Yeah, there has to be a negative consequence. Nicely done. Excellent. There has to be a negative consequence to it. That's what makes it a sin. It isn't a sin just because God is offended. Okay? If that's part of your thinking, get rid of that. Okay? God is not a big monster up there with this big ego that just gets offended all the time when we do things that he told us not to. Okay? God is not like that. God said, don't do that. Why? Because it's going to hurt us if we do it. Okay? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So what makes a sin a sin?
It hurts us.
It hurts us. The consequences make it a sin. Now, when it comes to premarital sex, when it comes to sex, we have a continuum. And it's important to recognize this continuum. It's called the sex continuum. All right, and this is the way it works. Over here, we have really bad, bad stuff, and over here, we have really good stuff, okay? And what would be the really, really bad expression of premarital sex, do you think?
Rape.
No, not rape. Rape is something else entirely.
One night stand.
One night stand. One night stand. How many people here think that a one-night stand is okie-dokie? You do, eh? Yeah, Bernadette's giving him a show.
It's mutual and respectful, and it's with the person and not the body, then what's wrong with it?
Okay, good. I'm glad somebody said that. What's wrong with it as long as it's mutual and respectful? But it's a one-night stand. The idea of the one-night stand is you've just met this person, okay? You don't know them from Shinola. And are there negative consequences that come from a one-night stand? Who can think of some? Yep.
Pregnancy.
Might get pregnant. Oh, yeah, you're playing with money. You're gambling with money that you don't have. What else? What's another negative consequence to a one-night stand? We're keeping it to that specific example. Yep.
More of the long-term business.
Say again?
More of
Okay, yeah, STDs is another one. But say you're using birth control and say you're using condoms, so you could rule out the possibility of STDs, most likely, and you're probably not going to get pregnant. Is it okay then?
No.
No, why not?
Self-gratification.
Self-gratification. Are you doing it because you love someone else? No, you're doing it because you want to get your rocks off for you. It's a selfish act. Is it an act of love? You don't even know this person. It's not an act of love. Yep.
It could hurt your self-esteem and hurt you. You know.
Yes, it could hurt your self-esteem big time. Big time. How can it hurt your self-esteem, a one-night stand?
Guilt.
Guilt, uh-huh, yep.
Feel used.
Feel like you are an object. Even the mutual agreement to allow yourselves to be used as objects is demeaning, right? Even if you mutually agree, it's still demeaning. You're still letting yourself be a piece of meat. You're still using somebody else as a piece of meat, right? I mean, you're turning someone else into a living masturbation tool, basically.
It's disrespectful.
It is.
Loves us, and that's why you're treating
them. Yeah. It's disrespectful to us. It's disrespectful to the other person. I agree. Anybody else? Yep.
Since the must be a body and a spirit, and by gratifying the body, you're neglecting the spiritual aspect of our human being, we're becoming glutton.
Yeah.
Not becoming more animalistic.
I agree with that. I agree that there isn't a lot of self-discipline there. It's about following our impulses rather than controlling ourselves. That can be the case. It isn't always, but it certainly can be. Absolutely. Yep.
It's actually a physical hormone that's released that bonds you to that person.
Ah. Exactly. And I'm glad you mentioned that. There is a hormone that is released when you have a sexual connection with someone that bonds you psychologically to that other person. And the more often we do it, the more we can suppress that kind of a notion, that kind of an experience of that feeling, but it's still there. And it's beating on our self-esteem. And we can ignore the beating, but it's still there. Absolutely. There's something called the more that you repeat any sin, the more your culpability goes down. What that means is the more you repeat it, the less guilty you feel about it. But that's only because you're numbing yourself to your conscience. It's only because you're just cutting off those nerves. You know, you just say the same thing about shoplifting. The more often you do it, the easier it gets, you know? You just, no problem, I'll just slip it in my bag. We don't even think about it anymore.
That's just like speeding, eh?
It is exactly like speeding. Yes, I admit it, I'm guilty. It is just like speeding. I am a terrible sinner when I'm behind the wheel. All my wrath comes out. You in the back.
I wonder, it's a question, do you think maybe a lot of these were considered sin at the time because they didn't understand how to stop pregnancies and
No. I think that was part of it, but the reality is they recognized the fact that when two become one, this is right in the story of Adam and Eve, when the two become one flesh, they're united. And that's why, in fact, when premarital sex was practiced in biblical times, for example, say, guy sees good-looking girl as he's walking down the road, and she's there taking care of the crops, and they really like each other, and they have sex, guess what has to happen next?